morning. It's the highest number of new cases in this outbreak. New South Wales recording 136 COVID cases in the past 24 hours, with 53 of those infectious in the community. Chris O'Keefe joins me now in studio. Chris, some new restrictions for more local government areas.
Yeah, so the local government areas of Blacktown and Cumberland will now be have some pretty harsh restrictions on them, similar to what we've already seen in Fairfield, Liverpool and Canterbury-Bankstown. If you want to leave for essential work, you must get a test every 3 days if you live in those two local government areas. If you are not on the authorised worker list, you are not to go to work. It's as simple as that. You are not legally allowed to work under these new public health orders. This will come into effect at midnight tonight. Now, it was almost a feeling that New South Wales had almost lost control of this, and the public health measures that are in place right now are just not working. With 136 new cases, 53 in the community, not only is the overall number not coming down, but the number in the community is going the wrong way. It is going up exponentially, really, at the moment. So what they've decided to do, the Premier and the Chief Health Officer in New South Wales, is call this a national emergency. So Gladys Berejiklian will go to National Cabinet this afternoon, and she will ask all the other state and territory leaders to redirect priority of vaccines into southwest and western Sydney. The simple reason for that is, if Sydney fails, Australia fails. And how we're tracking at the moment is simple. We are not getting on top of this, and it's only vaccines, according to the New South Wales government, that will really turn this around. Now, specifically, we saw the Chief Health Officer today say, if you are under 40, if you are of any age, if you're over 16 even, consider going to get AstraZeneca. We know we have lots and lots of doses of AstraZeneca, and you can get that from your GP very easily. And Dr. Chant today simply said this is the only way out of what is now becoming a very, very dire situation.
I have advised the government today that this is a national emergency and requires additional measures to reduce the case numbers. What we are seeing is that the actions taken to date have averted many cases, but what we are not seeing is the turnaround that we would have liked to see at this stage. And I am concerned that we need to put in place urgent additional measures. What I'm recommending strongly is that our vaccination efforts are refocused on those affected LGAs.
Now, this is quickly becoming a crisis for the entire country. In the New Zealand travel bubble, it is understood, we understand, Nine News understands, that the New Zealand government will suspend, cancel the Trans-Tasman bubble this afternoon for at least until September. That is for every single jurisdiction in Australia. So if you have a holiday booked to New Zealand, that will be cancelled. And it's understood that Jacinda Ardern will tell Kiwis currently in Australia, you have 1 week to get home. Otherwise, they're not coming in.
Thanks, Chris. Chris O'Keefe there with that breaking news. Victoria has recorded 14 new cases of COVID, and the number of exposure sites in the state is nearing 400. But in promising news, most of the positive tests were in isolation while infectious. Isabella Stashkovsky explains.
Well, 14 new COVID cases have been recorded in Victoria. The good news is that all are linked and at least 10 were isolating throughout their entire infectious period. But there has been a COVID scare at an aged care home in Melbourne. Mequacare here in Hoppers Crossing plunged into lockdown as a result. The Today Show understands a resident from this facility was brought back from hospital before his COVID results were received, despite that being requested by the 101-bed centre. It's further understood the fully vaccinated man returned an initial week positive, then a negative, following more tests. It's possible the week positive was because he's a historic COVID case. Meanwhile, a staff member at Casey Hospital has tested positive, sending 41 staff into isolation, while around 900 people are in isolation after a positive case went to the popular Paran markets. Authorities have said they're confident the lockdown is working and restrictions could ease next week. Lockdown 5, meanwhile, has now reached the threshold for the COVID-19 disaster payment. Eligible Victorians can apply, and the easiest way to do so is through the MyGov website.
More than 100 South Australians have woken up this morning in hotel quarantine, deemed close contacts of positive cases at two high-risk exposure sites. Live to Oliver Haig, who is outside one of Adelaide's Medi hotels. Ollie, health authorities are calling this double ring fencing.
Yeah, that's exactly right, Lizzie. Out of around the 200 or so people that were at the Tenerife Winery and also the Greek on Halifax restaurant, which has now been deemed a high-risk exposure site where super spreading event has occurred, around 100 have now been brought to Medi hotels. Many brought to here at the Pullman late last night, where they've woken up this morning and spent their first morning in hotel quarantine. Now, all of this is because of the risks that it does pose to the community. Authorities are now treating these people exactly the same as they would for international travellers. And now, some good news on the testing front. Yesterday, we did see some people wait long times for testing, up to 14 hours to get a test, but those queues now have dramatically died down despite the list of exposure sites increasing. The Health Minister has also confirmed a review will be undertaken on our state's testing system, with more testing sites to come online, including two private clinics that were public. They are coming online today, as well as the Defence Force is now being deployed across testing sites across the state to render assistance. And just in some breaking news, we have recorded one new local case in South Australia today that is linked to the winery, and that person is currently in quarantine. Lizzie?
Thanks, Ollie. Ollie Haig there in Adelaide for us. There's early frustration on the now closed Queensland border with New South Wales, with drivers forced to wait several hours to get through checkpoints. Reece D'Alessandro has more.
Well, we've seen frustration at massive queues here on the Gold Coast this morning. This is the Gold Coast Highway checkpoint leading into Queensland. This is one of three major road checkpoints where we've seen major delays this morning. Drivers coming through here telling us they've been waiting up to 2 hours to get into Queensland. Police urging motorists to plan ahead and to also pack their patience. Aerial pictures showing it's not just been difficult for those on their way to work, but for those who've been working as well. At Coolangatta in particular, tradies were filmed passing materials across one of the hard border barriers. Some confusion as well over the new border pass system introduced at 1 a.m.
I'm just hoping this pass will get me through, because when I went to bed last night, we still couldn't get on to get the new one. So this one's still valid. Fingers crossed, I'll get through.
I'm delivering bread. I crossed the border a couple of times. It's going to get worse.
The first two or three days is always a bit challenging on our border situation.
Restrictions have been eased in Queensland, but the mask mandate will remain in place for another week. These border checkpoints to remain in place for at least another 4 weeks.
Vaccinating Australians against COVID is poised to step up a notch with moves to deliver jabs to some teenagers. Politics reporter Jonathan Kersley is live from Canberra for us this morning. Jono, what information have we got on this?
Well, Lizzie, Health Minister Greg Hunt is optimistic, talking about 12 to 15-year-olds who are immunosuppressed being added to the Pfizer rollout in weeks. But more broadly, the vaccine needs to get to the rest of the adult population and older teenagers first. So realistically, the whole 12 to 15-year-old population will likely be waiting months and months and months for a Pfizer vaccine. Prior to today, the regulator approved it for 16-year-olds, but they are still a long way from receiving it. Epidemiologists say more data needs to be collected from other countries before consideration is given to vaccinating children. The health minister suggests the rollout could reach younger teens before the end of the year.
Then ensure that there's rollout during the course of 2021 through a combination of schools and general access.
It's going to be quite some time before they can even join the line.
Supply has been the major issue with Pfizer, Lizzie, but when it comes to AstraZeneca, Nine News has learned 3.4 million doses of the vaccine have been distributed to vaccine sites across the country, but not yet used, essentially sitting in fridges. That's more than a quarter of all doses sent by CSL to the government. The rollout's been under the microscope here in Canberra this morning as the regulator revealed Moderna could be approved early next month. The Army General in charge of the rollout, Lieutenant General John Frewen, also said vaccine doses given to Australians has more than doubled in the 6 weeks he's been in the job compared to the previous 16 weeks, and he's looking to speed things up further.
We're looking at all of the options, from mass vaccination clinics, pop-up clinics, pharmacies, as I've mentioned, because what I seek to have now, as we have that greater supply, is a greater diversity of distribution points.
His plan, including a major boost to the workforce, will be put to National Cabinet this afternoon, Lizzie.
Jono Kersley there for us in Canberra.